Ha! That is not an issue, bro.
Oh my.
If I go around telling people this, they'll think I'm crazy.
Inevitably, one out of five, I have like a ah!
I feel most alive probably when I'm surfing. Yeah, definitely when I'm surfing. I'm a stand-up paddleboarder, and I surf this big, stand-up board. And I love nothing more than the connection with nature at the same time as the competition with the other surfers. I think it's a beautiful blend of the masculine and the feminine in my life.
Oh boy. Well, certainly it helps to wake up every day. And one of the things that I'm a sunset chaser. You know, I just love a good sunset particularly into the ocean. So I love being at the ocean. I love watching sunsets, and that's often when I feel most alive. It's pretty much always in nature.
Oh my, I'm always when I wake up every part of the day. No, when I feel alive there are such a lot of places and situations. When I feel dead is when there's alienation. When I feel alive is connectedness. Intimacy is amazing. I always say there are the two great intimacies with my wife and with God. It's amazing. This connectedness is beautiful for me. To see my children and to be able to have the privilege to speak into their lives. When I'm in nature, I feel connected to nature. Even the vast openness of the nothingness in the desert, or the lushness of the forests in the Drakensberg, in the mountains. So this is when I feel alive. Another place when I feel alive is when the spark of creativity. The greatest thing is to think out new things. It is this moment of creativity that you say, wow, the things are coming together. This is creating something new. Only God creates out of nothing, but to put things in a new way together. This is making me feel alive. And you guess what? To speak to great people like you, connecting with people like you is making me feel alive.
I am dairy intolerant, so probably like a vegan cheese. Something. One of those. Yeah, it sucks, man, because I like pizza is my favorite thing in the whole wide world, but I haven't had gluten, dairy, sugar, soy, eggs for years.
Mozzarella.
Mozzarella, string cheese.
Heavy cheddar.
Goat cheese, mainly because I thought I was lactose intolerant, but I could have goat cheese. However, I just did a test and I had like 5 slices of pizza and I was fine. So I think I just thought that I was lactose intolerant when I really wasn't.
The Way of the Peaceful Warrior. It's a philosophical book, and it just spoke to me, man. It spoke to me.
Can I grab the book real quick? It's called The Slight Edge by Jeff Olson, turning simple disciplines into massive success and happiness. So The Slight Edge, yeah. It's a great book about doing those little things, those little habits that become massive changes in your life that send you on a trajectory up or down.
There's a book called Chase the Lion. And it really centers around, there's a scripture in Samuel that talks about essentially the, somebody going into the pit to chase a lion. And, you know, to me, you know, you kind of read over certain things and then you go, you know, like, what? And the whole book is about essentially like taking your life by the reins and really deciding what you will do intentionally with your life. And so it was interesting for me because, you know, you sit there and you go, wait, somebody went, chased the lion into a pit and came out victorious. And you kind of go like, I mean, how does that even happen? You know what I mean? So I think that was probably one, because I was probably at a low point in my life. And it was one of those things where it kind of allowed me to grasp enough energy to really be intentional about what I want my life to be like now that it has, you know, because it had changed, right? So,
Leading with Gratitude by Chester Elton. It is a book that dives into the business and the case studies and the possibilities of devoting a life to gratitude. Also, a close tie would be Empathy, Why It Matters and How to Get It by Roman Krznarek, founder of the School of Life.
Oh, come on. Over.
No toilet paper. No, I'm just kidding.
Oh, definitely over. Who does under? Is that a thing?
Over. Over. Of course.
I don't even know why it's a debate.
Exactly. I'm like, are you kidding me right now? I can't. You see how excited
yeah, it's over.
No, okay. Stuff. I'm like, no.
Under.
Oh my gosh.
Maybe I just like to do things differently. How about that?
I'm kind of the contrarian. So I think the contrary position is under.
It is.
You know, just to be different. Yeah, think like I was an Apple fan. Think differently.
Over. There's actually an old advertisement from like the late 1800s from the original inventor of toilet paper showing that it's over, so it's been proven. Anybody who goes under is clearly a heathen and doesn't belong here.
Ooh. Night at the Roxbury is the one that comes to mind. I think I may have walked out on that movie when, because I saw it in the movie theaters. I think I walked out.
There's a movie called Out Cold with Zach Galifianakis. You know how Zach Galifianakis is like funny, but also ridiculous and
yep.
Terrible. It was like one of his first movies.
I really liked Pineapple Express. I don't know if you ever saw that. It's like a stoner flick and super violent and super like just not conscious at all. But I remember when I saw it, I just cracked up because it was so ridiculous.
I really, really like Night of the Roxbury or Night at the Roxbury. And it is so cheesy and so hilarious. And I love the songs, the terrible 90s dance music. I'm a fan.
When I went on America's Got Talent and I totally bombed. And in that moment, I was distraught. I was defeated because I had failed at the thing that defined me, right? That was my job title. And I had failed at it, fallen flat on my face. But through that process of getting comfortable inside of the discomfort, I held space, took the lessons, and then that became a catalyst for me to, you know, elevate to the next level, man.
I think the biggest failure I made was staying in the job that I really didn't, or in the industry that I really didn't want to be in anymore, and which resulted in me basically being fired. And but the funny thing is that I expected to be fired. I went in knowing that I'm going to get fired because I'm just passing the time and doing my thing. And to me, that's a big failure for accepting that and for accepting that lot in life. And I shouldn't do something that I'm not happy about or that didn't bring me joy or pleasure.
Ending up in hospital with brain surgery. That was when I had the wake-up call and I realized that there's more to life than just working for money.
The time when my arms stopped working at work. So I worked for 21 days straight without a day off, and after an 18-hour day with Bad Ergonomics, my arms stopped working. And it was the journey to heal, change my work, and also change some of the emotional stuff that even made an injury like that possible.
I used to want to rid myself of insecurity. I used to want to be perfect. And when I overcame that, I realized that my insecurities, my unique the things that go against me, the things that hold me back, are what make me beautiful. And I find a lot more peace with myself that way.
For me, I would say it was getting expelled from high school. You know, at that point in time, your life is all about your friends. And for me, it was basketball and sports. Both of those things were taken away from me. And ultimately, kind of the end of that road was getting to be able to go to college. And all three of those were ultimately on the chopping block and taken away from me. And it was something that really, when hitting rock bottom, taught me, no matter how challenging or how hard life gets, if you decide that you want a different outcome, you have the ability to design and create that for yourself with hard work and just doing what you need to do. And so that was the biggest thing that I feel like has really set me up for a lot of success, not just in business, but also in many areas of my life.
Going out for ice cream?
I've never really been like an ice cream kind of a guy. And so like my wife really loves ice cream. And so we've been better now. So we don't eat as much. Actually, we stopped buying like 2 weeks ago, but we would have ice cream in our freezer. And so like, I guess that was kind of a frivolous thing.
Some people would say this is frivolous, but I think it's deep. But getting my nails done. So this is like self-expression, you know, like I have galaxy nails right now. So you can see all the possibilities because this is what I've been into lately. So
this is a recent frivolous and it was so fun and totally not frivolous. I got an animal totem reading done. So I was researching animal totems and spirit guides on the internet and I found a blog and I really liked this woman's writing and I thought, I just want to talk to her. I just want to meet her. And I saw that the easiest way to do that was to schedule a session with her and do an animal totem reading. So I got on a call with someone I didn't know on the internet and asked her some questions that were important to me. And then she showed me, you know, she both did a reading and she also told me about how she does readings and the process of doing readings. And it was so delightful. I learned so much. And I also feel like if I go around telling people this, they'll think I'm crazy. But it's so fun. It was so good. We told everyone.
I enjoy watching TV with my wife every night. I like to shut off the computer. I work out of my home, as you can see. I have the home office, which I love. And I have a 17-second commute from the bedroom to the office here. And, what feels great is stopping work. You know, I just love stopping working because I saw my dad, you know, work all the time, 12, 14, 16 hours every day, worked really, really hard, kind of like what you shared in our interview, Steve, with your dad. And my dad was just the same. And you know, we do appreciate him. I appreciate him for that. He was taking care of us and you know, trying to feed the family and so forth. But it just feels so good to stop working, you know, and say, I'm done for the night, you know, and just say, just shut off the computer and say, bye-bye, we'll see you tomorrow. It just feels great.
Space to clear your head. Almost every single business idea that I have ever had has been when I'm walking. That's my thing that works for me. My poor husband, we go on big long walks together a lot, and inevitably one out of five I have like I get that's my creative space, but it's for everyone it's different. So it's finding that time that your brain can just rest for a minute.
Ha! That is not an issue, bro. I've got to like throw some sand on the fire, dude. It's too much. It's like when people say, oh, let's think outside of the box. I'm like, no, give me a box, please. Please give me a box because there's too much out there. It's like when I have a box, then I can paint the walls whatever color. I can lay some kind of trampoline down on the ground. I can suspend something from the ceiling and swing from it. I can bounce things off of it. For me, I need that box. So it's the opposite. My spectrum is like over here with creativity. So I need some of this like linearness to like bring it down,
channel it. There we go.
One way for me to stay creative is to try different things out. Like I'm learning new languages. I'm actually learning two languages. I'm learning Spanish and Hawaiian, two completely different things. But what it is allowing my brain to do is work in different ways and solve puzzles and recognize patterns. And then also with the piano, I'm trying different things out. I'm playing chord scales using both my left and right hand. And actually my brain is actually having a fight. Someone asked me, which is better, the left hand or the right hand? I go, well, they work together. It's my brain that's struggling. My left brain is trying to tell my right brain what to do. And it's screwing everything up. And the right brain says, okay, I understand what you're trying to tell me. I got this, leave me alone, let me do my thing. And so it's working out sort of, you know, the struggle between the left brain and right brain, and using, you know, language and musical instruments, it's allowing me to be creative, which I believe is also helping me make decisions as far as my career of what the things I'm gonna do. It's helping me solve that puzzle of what should I do next and make my transition.
For me, it's always been my morning and my evening routine. If I am setting myself up for success in the morning, and I'm also planning for success the next day at night, it allows me to get in with ultimate clarity on what I've identified as being the most important things aligned with the outcomes that I desire and when I desire them by, for giving me the best chance to show up and get the traction and get the momentum and ultimately get the results that I'm looking for.
I would say the number one thing is scheduling the life, because the business often schedules itself. And so it's, for me, it's easier to have, you know, a lot of business and a little harder to have a lot of life. So I schedule my life in right into my business calendar, and I make sure that I show up for those meetings and I treat them like business meetings. Not, I don't mean that I go there all business, but it's as important to be there on time, fully present, you know, 100% for my life.
You know what it is I actually go for a walk with my wife. We like to just go for a walk in nature. That gets me out of the house, out of the office, and out in nature. And there are numerous studies that show that just being in nature, even for 10, 15 minutes, has a huge effect on your lowering your stress, increasing your gratitude, just increasing the airflow in your body, and all of those things. So that's what I like to do to have. And what's nice is I have all of these automated funnels going, so I'm still making money even when I'm out going for a walk.
Clearly articulating what your purpose is.
The number one thing I do is to plan my day. Plan tomorrow today. That's it.
The most important thing is not to see it either or. So it's either business or life. Life is business, business is life. And if you do not have an integrated life, I always ask people when they say, I'm having a difficult time, I can't get things together. There's one person who always says, if you ask me, how are you? He said, I'm together, man. And you ask a lot of other people, so I'm falling apart, man. Because I'm focusing here, I'm at work, and then I'm guilty that I'm not at home. And when I'm at home, I'm guilty that I'm not in work. You need integration. You need togetherness. You need a life plan. You need an integrated life plan. Otherwise, you will win the world and lose your health, lose your family, lose your marriage, lose your soul. So have an integrated. It's not either or. It's both and. And a life of balance is purposefully going and living your life and making sure that all the spokes of the wheel are functioning. Health, family, and money.
Focus equals growth. When you find something you're passionate about, when you find something that brings you joy, not happiness. Happiness is episodic. Joy is everlasting. When you find something that starts to work on your soul, keep at it and keep doing it so long and so frequently that one day you become the best in the world at it, and you gain, you know, gain joy from that craft.
I think that especially for younger entrepreneurs, you have to be fiscally responsible. It's really tempting to get the house on the hill and the big badass car, and those things end up owning you. You know, it's not more business, more life, more things. And I'm not wealth bashing, because if you're all into cars, man, go get the Ferrari and the Lamborghini and all the things. But just be careful as to how leveraged you allow yourself to be, because those are the things that really start to own you at the end if you're not careful.
Decide what life you want to live
first, and what does that mean to you? How much free time do you want? How many hours do you actually want to work? When do you want to start your day? Like, I like starting at like 9:30 or 10 because I like doing self-care, meditation, prayer, exercise before I start my day. Decide for you what works and then start scheduling your business life through that and around that with, of course, exceptions, but structure your life and then structure your business.
I think it's going to have to be breaks, taking breaks. And I have a manager for that. That's my dog. She tells me when to take breaks. She gets very upset if I don't take breaks.